So as most of you know, Apple went ahead and released these new MacBooks to everyone, the 16-inch and 14-inch MacBooks. So let's go ahead and discuss which specific MacBook you should pick up in the later part of 2021. Now, I'm going to cover pretty much all of them, the MacBook Airs, the M1 MacBook Pros, and the M1 Max and Pro MacBooks as well. And here's the thing that I'll tell you. If you are a power user and you have all the money in the world to spend, I truly do think getting the 14-inch or 16-inch MacBooks, preferably the 16-inch MacBook, is the best way to go. You know, if you want to future-proof yourself for as long as possible, that is the way I would recommend. But me personally, I probably wouldn't feel comfortable spending like that much money on a MacBook like that when I know that my M1 MacBook Pro that I've been using, the 13-inch one, for the last 7 months has so much power, and it's even more powerful than what I need it to be. It's like overpowered for my daily tasks. Now, me personally, I make like 10 videos a day probably. I'm in Final Cut Pro exporting videos all the time, and my M1 MacBook Pro has been a champ. It's been able to handle everything I throw at it. So I truly do think, and I feel very comfortable with me recommending that M1 MacBook Pro, the 13-inch one. The starting price of that is $1,299. And if your tasks include, you know, like programming and compiling code and editing videos all the time, editing photos, if you're a student and you're writing up papers, I really do think getting the 13-inch M1 MacBook Pro is probably that sweet spot between performance and probably portability as well. If you don't need a lot of ports, if you don't need an SD card, and if you're not plugging in a lot of things to your MacBook, I think that M1 MacBook Pro, the 13-inch one, is the best way I would recommend. Now, I also do think that the M1 MacBook Air, the $999 model, is a superb device with a ton of capability as well. Now, do keep in mind that the performance between an M1 MacBook Pro 13-inch and the M1 MacBook Air, there really isn't that crazy big of a difference. I think it has one less core, but in the grand scheme of things, it really doesn't matter too much. And for $200 less or $300 less than the M1 MacBook Pro 13-inch, you're really not missing out on too much, and you're saving a lot of money, and you're almost getting the same thing, and there's a lot more portability with that device. So for $1,000, I think that's an even better way to go for a lot of you, but it really just depends on how much money you want to save. But in reality, they pretty much do the same exact thing, so I wouldn't even matter about that too much. Now, on top of that, another massive thing to keep in mind is that the 14-inch MacBook Pro starts at $1,999. So the jump is $1,000 more than an M1 MacBook Air, but it's also hundreds of dollars more than the M1 MacBook Pro 13-inch. Now, with that additional jump, you are getting a lot of different things. So you're able to spec out the storage to many more terabytes more. You have more ports with MagSafe, and you get a USB Type-C port on each side, which is something I really do prefer. You have three USB Type-C ports in general for both the 14-inch and the 16-inch models. You have bigger displays, which is beautiful, and they are ProMotion displays as well, which is amazing. Now, the SD card is the one thing I like. I like having that, you know, actual port on my device to plug in and plug out, but I will tell you, if you don't care about the ports, if you don't care about the HDMI port, you don't care about MagSafe, and you don't care about the SD card, there's still a lot of capability with these cheaper M1 MacBook Air and M1 MacBook Pros that you really don't have to jump up to the 14-inch or 16-inch ones. If you're comfortable spending the money, then those are the better ways to go because they do have more capability. They're going to future-proof yourself for a while, but I do think those MacBooks are better value per dollars and better value per performance as well. Now, this is another thing I'll tell you. If you're trying to do the most amount of stuff on a MacBook, and I'm talking about you're doing huge projects, you're editing 8K video or 4K at 60 all the time, ProRes video as well, you need the most amount of performance possible, then something like an M1 MacBook Pro, the 14-inch one, may be the better way to go, or the 16-inch one. You do have to keep in mind that the biggest difference between these two is the sizes between the 14-inch and 16-inch one. Versus something like a 13-inch M1 MacBook Pro and a 14-inch M1 MacBook Pro, you can spec these things out to be kind of similar, but the 14-inch MacBook Pro is going to be the better performing one. You know, the maxed out 13-inch M1 MacBook Pro is less powerful than the maxed out 14-inch M1 MacBook Pro. So that's a big thing to keep in mind. However, between the 14-inch MacBook Pro and the 16-inch MacBook Pro, you can get them to the same exact speed. There really isn't a difference there. You know, it depends how much money you have, but the maxed out both of these models pretty much have the same type of capability. So that's a big thing to keep in mind. The battery life, though, is something that just doesn't really make too much sense to me for these specific MacBooks. Now, here's the thing. For the M1 MacBook Pro, Apple on their own website, first of all, personally, I've had really good battery life on this specific MacBook. It's handled everything I threw at it, and it's beautiful. I've had a great experience with it. But the M1 MacBook Pro on their website states that they can go up to 20 hours of battery life. So without running my own tests and just using my MacBook over and over again, I would say that's about accurate. Now with their M1 MacBook Air, they actually estimate that it gets up to 18 hours of battery life. So 2 hours less than the actual M1 MacBook Pro. So it's kind of expected. I was expecting the M1 MacBook Air to be better, but both of them have tremendous battery life, which is great for that price tag at $999 and $1299 respectively. But here's the thing. With the M1 MacBook Pro 14-inch model, so the M1 Pro and M1 Max, because of that ProMotion display, Apple on their own website states that it only gets up to 17 hours of battery life. Now, I do think if you go ahead and turn that display down to 60 hertz, then maybe it helps out, but you don't want to do that. That's one of the main features of this MacBook. It's like taking out the ports. There's no point in doing that. Then you might as well go for a cheaper MacBook. But here's the thing. With that extra money, the hundreds and hundreds of dollars more, even $1,000 more than the M1 MacBook Air, on their own website, they are saying that you're getting less battery life on a 14-inch MacBook Pro that costs $2,000 than the M1 MacBook Air that costs $1,000. So if battery life is something that's important to you, getting an M1 MacBook Air, especially that M1 MacBook Pro, may be the better value for you, especially when a per dollar standpoint. But that 16-inch MacBook Pro, that massive size, you know, display, that massive size computer, gets 21 hours of battery life on their own website again. I'm sure in real life use, if you compare the here and there, I'm sure they would be, you know, a little bit up in the air, a little bit different. But these are consistent numbers that they tested, and I'm taking it from the, you know, word of their mouth. 21 hours of battery life compared to the 18 hours on the M1 MacBook Air, that's pretty cool. So you're getting a much better battery life there, but compared to that M1 MacBook Pro, it's only an additional hour, you know, compared to the M1 MacBook Pro 16-inch. So even in a battery sense, you're really not getting too much better battery life from an M1 MacBook Pro to that 16-inch 2021 model of the, you know, MacBook Pro, M1 Pro, or M1 Max model. So when it comes down to that, that really showcases to me that, hey, if you want the best battery life, getting that 16-inch MacBook Pro is a better way to go, but it's only an additional hour than the M1 MacBook Pro. And the worst one out of all four of these models is the 14-inch M1 MacBook Pro. So I don't really get why Apple did this. I mean, they could have put a bigger battery, I'm not too sure. I guess we'll see what happens in the future. But ultimately, like I mentioned, if you have the money, getting that 16-inch M1 MacBook Pro is the best way to go. It's the best battery life. You can spec it out to be the craziest, and it has so much capability. But if you're trying to, in my opinion, get the best bang for your dollar, I truly do think something like an M1 MacBook Air may be the best way to go for you. If you're someone who's kind of in the middle and you don't want to get the M1 MacBook Air, maybe you want the fans and the cooling system and a little bit better of a performing machine, I think the M1 MacBook Pro is the one I would recommend to a lot of people. And here's the funny thing. I was already planning on switching to my 14-inch MacBook Pro that I already have, but after kind of doing these comparisons and looking at the numbers and looking at everything, it may make sense to actually keep the M1 MacBook Pro for the time being. It has better battery life, it's much cheaper, and to be honest, the performance is more than enough for me. The ports was the best thing about it, but the trade-off for worse battery life is not something I'm willing to do. I guess we'll see what happens in the future, but hopefully this kind of clears it out for you a little bit. If you guys have any questions or anything, let me know in the comment section below. Hit the like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. More importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.